let's look at the example how to find out the inverse of a given matrix. And here there are two examples. Example A, first one is on the left. Okay, the second one is on the right. Let's work on the first one. You see, for a given matrix, how to find out the inverse, here are the steps. Okay, you want to write 5, negative 4, 1, 2 on the left. Right hand side is 1, 0, 0, 1. So, using the raw elementary operations, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, 4 steps. Then you can change 5, negative 4, 1, 2 to 1, 0, 0, 1. Whatever you end up with on the right hand side from here to here, this one will be the inverse of the one here, or you may say the given matrix here. Okay, so there's a game. So let's look at that. 5, negative 4, 1, 2, and you just put 1, 0, 0, 1 here. Your goal is to change from here to here. Make the left-hand side be like 1, 0, 0, 1, as it looked right here. And then whatever it end up with, this one will be the inverse of the one right here. Now, look. We like this place be 1, but we don't like fractional numbers. So what we do is we exchange row 1 and row 2. Here's what we did. 1, 2, 0, 1, row 2 comes to be 1, 2, 0, 1, row 1, and 5, negative 4, 1, 0 comes to be the second row. So step 1 is quite easy. Okay? Step 2. We want to eliminate this place. Because, you know, we want this place to be 0. Okay? Because the goal is here is 1, here is 0. We already made this place be 1. See? By exchanging those two rows. Then, okay, step 2 is to make this place be 0. In order to make this place be 0, I like to multiply the row 1 by negative 5. So I wrote row 1 multiplied by negative 5. Okay. 1 times negative 5 is negative 5. 2 times negative 5 is negative 10. 0 times negative 5 is 0. 1 times negative 5 is negative 5. Once we get negative 5, I want to add onto the row 2. So I said row 1 times negative 5, which gives us the blue numbers, and add onto row 2. Got the new row 2. What do we get? Row 2, negative 5, positive 5 cancel each other. Negative 5, positive 5 canceled. Negative 10, negative 4, negative 15. 0 plus 1, 1. Negative 5 plus 0, negative 5. So you see, with those two steps, we already have 1, 0 here. Okay. Now we are here. Then two more steps, we are done. So we like this place be 1, because this place will be 1. Okay. So I like this place be 1. This place be 1, it was negative 14, so I divide row 2 by negative 14. Okay, so I wrote row 2 divided by negative row 14 here comes to be a new row 2. That's easier. 0 times negative 14 is 0. Negative 14 times negative 14 is 1. Fractional number appears. 1 over negative 14 is 1 over negative 14, right here. And then negative 5, negative 14, positive 5 over 14. Huh, we are closer. We are close than before, closer than before. And here we want this one be 0, then we are done. So, then I like to use is root 2 multiplied by negative 2. Okay? So you may say, you may write here, let me use a red pen or probably pencil to find out. So you see right here, yeah, root 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. Okay, right here. So that's why I put right here, root 2 times negative 2. So 0 times negative 2 is the blue number, 0. 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. And negative 1 fourth times negative 2 is the blue number, positive 2. 14s are not 4, yeah, not 1 4, okay, 14. Okay, now here, 5 over 14 times negative 2 is negative 10 14s. So, after row 2 times negative 2, we got blue numbers. Then we add on that. You see, negative 2, positive 2 cancel each other, so we have a 0. Here, 0 plus 1, still you have a 0. And then negative 2 plus 2, we have a 0 here. And then 2 over 14 plus 0, 2 over 14 is 1 seventh. Okay. Yeah. And then you see 5 times 5 over 14 times negative 2, negative 2 upstairs and then 14 downstairs. Yeah, you can do the cancellation, but right here we keep the blue number, negative 10, positive 14. Okay. So 2 over 14, you add on that, that's 1 seventh, and the blue number you add on that, 1 is what? 1 is 14 over 14. 14 minus 10 is 4, okay? And 14 is denominator, you keep it. So 1 0 1 0 1 4 7th, and then 4 over 14. Downstairs we keep the black number. It's still 0 1, negative 1 14th, yeah, 5 over 14th. So we didn't do anything with the first, the second one. We keep it. Okay. The only thing we did right here is was blue number add on the black number in the first row. So we get new black numbers. Make sense? 0, 1 together is 1. Negative 2, positive 2 is 0. And here we have a blue number on the black. 2 over 14 is 1 seventh, add on 0. And here negative 10 over 14, add on 1, is 4 over 14. Because 1 is 14 over 14, 14 minus 10 is 4. 14 denominator, we keep it. So we end up with this one, and this one is actually the inverse of the A. Okay, of the A. So 1 over 7, negative 1 over 14, 4 over 14 is 2 over 7. Okay, 1 over 14, 5 over 14, 5 over 14. So the inverse of this one is this one, or this one has the inverse of this one. Those, one is the inverse of another. And here you can put it back to check. Okay, you check yourself. Those are details. It means A times this one, you have a 1 0 0 1. And here are the details. A, this is our A. And the inverse, this is the inverse. Okay, A is this A, and the inverse is this one. Okay, and here are details. You end up with 1001. That's the identity matrix. Okay. So now let's look at this one. This one, again, the gain is the same. 9 -6, 6 -4. 9 -6, 6 -4. You wanted to put 1001 here to see if you can end up with something like 1001. Whatever you get here will be the inverse. Okay. So look. We like this number b1, so you divide it by 9. The first rule divided by 9, 9 divided by 9 is 1, negative 6 divided by 9 is negative 2/3, 1 divided by 9 is 1/9, 0 divided by 9 is 0. The second rule, you don't change it, you keep it. Okay. So that's why we said row 1 divided by 9 is comes to be a new row 1 like this. Now make this place be 0. So row 2, row 1 times negative 6. You see, we need negative 6 to cancel positive 6. That means black number, each black number times the red number negative 6. You get blue number. Okay? 1 times negative 6 is negative 6. Negative 2/3 times negative 6. Negative negative comes to be positive 4. 2/3 times 6 is 4. And negative 2 negatives positive. And negative 6 times 1/9 is negative 2/3. And 0 times negative 6 is 0. So blue number add on black number, you get this one. See, negative 6, positive 6, 0. Positive 4, negative 4, 0. Negative 2/3 plus 0, negative 2/3. And 0, blue number add on black number is 1. You may think this is the inverse. No, the answer is no, because here has to be 1. You already found here is 0, 0. It's impossible to be here is 0, here is 1. Then this one cannot be the inverse. Okay? This value is not 1. I put the mark here. So the inverse of A does not exist for this one. Sometimes it has inverse. We found it. Sometimes this one does not have an inverse. So we say, so the inverse of A does not exist. Okay, now that's the 2x2. For the 3x3, that's a little bit harder. Okay, let's do this.